you as well. Some dark clouds overhead. We've had plenty of rain this morning, but the sunshine is peeking out a little bit now. We are told there might be a little bit more rain to come, which has us cowering in fear of our equipment up here in the commentary position as we're sitting out in the open, but hardy bunch that we are. We will get on with it, and we're looking forward to this very much because we're looking forward, first of all, to the men's K1, the kayak single, 1,000 metres, where Max Hoff is the world record holder and perhaps the favourite here, the German. But first of all, we will have the B final. Again, this is to settle the positions from 9th and down.
2 minutes to the start.
And these B finals have just been brought in for this Olympic Games for the first time. They have them in World Championships and European Championships, but here at the Olympics this is rather new, so all these men disappointed not to make the A final. And Cyril Carré goes in lane one for France, the 28-year-old fireman from Auxerre. In lane two, Marko Tomisevic from Serbia. Ben Fui from New Zealand competing in his third Olympic Games, a silver medalist in Athens in this event, fourth in Beijing, so not living up to those standards this year, sadly, in London. Jorge Antonio Garcia from Cuba, the Pan American Games champion. In lane number five from Bulgaria, Miroslav Kirchev. Seventh in the World Championships last year, so again, falling below his standards. Murray Stewart,
to the start.
A 26-year-old, born in South Africa, but attached to the Manly Warringah Kayak Club. Zhou Yubo from China, also competing in the 200 metres later on this week. And making up this B final, Mohamed Mrabet of Tunisia. Finished fifth in the K1 500 metres at the World Championships in Hungary last year. And so we're ready on fairly still water. No excuses for anybody in any of the lanes, which we like to see, because we like to see a fair race. Into the start buckets they go, which will drop when we're ready to race. Helen Reeves alongside me, and looking forward to this day of first day of finals.
Absolutely, it's a difficult one sometimes, these B finals, to get the athletes up for it, but they all want to make sure that they take out the lead and display why they should have perhaps been in that final.
France and Serbia, New Zealand, Cuba, Bulgaria, Australia, China, Tunisia, away we go in the first final of the day, the B final in the men's K1 1,000 metres, and they take it out with a surge of power and the stroke rate high, and then it will drop down into a rhythm. And at the moment, Marko Tomicevic of Serbia going along nicely, but Jorge Antonio Garcia of Cuba now beginning to set the pace.
See Garcia there already punching through his arms, driving through those legs, getting that boat really shifting forward. A nice flat rhythm he's got at the moment, the nose jumping about a fraction, which is not what we want to see. When the boat's running on a really smooth pattern, we see the nose of the boat cutting through the water like a knife.
And alongside Jorge Antonio Garcia, Miroslav Kirchev going well also from Bulgaria and through the 250 meter mark, quarter of the way. It is Garcia from Kirchev, Tomicevic, and then Cyril Carré of France, the first four.
Garcia really looking like he wants to take the win out here this morning, but Kirchev also side by side, edging up.
Beginning to make just a little bit of a move, Kirchev. Again, we saw from our wire cam on high the technique as they rock from side to side, the turn, the core strength and the shoulders and the back and the rhythm, always the rhythm, as these two take it out in front at the moment. And Marko Tomicevic from Serbia in third at the top of your picture.
Kirchev looking the more comfortable of the paddlers at the moment, still looking very relaxed through his shoulders, nice upright body position.
So these two nearly tied together, but Kirchev just beginning to make a little bit more headway now. And he takes it through. That is not quite right, the timing's going through there. Murray Stewart is not leading. Jorge Antonio Garcia alongside Kirchev, but also making a move now, Marko Tomicevic from Serbia, the 22-year-old, who's picking up ground as they head into the second half of this race.
That's what's interesting in the 1,000 metres. Each of these athletes have a game plan, have a race plan, what they're going to do. Some take it out hard and want to lead from the front, and others will come through, lead that burst for the final couple of hundred metres.
Just a sample of the noise to come as they approach the stands now, and this noise will certainly pick up for the A final, which involves our home hope in Tim Brabants. But these three now racing hard, racing well, locked together as they approach the 750 metre mark. The final quarter of the race to go, and that's how close it is. But now it is Tomicevic who takes them through from Serbia. And Cuba in second, Bulgaria with Kirchev in third, then Cyril Carey from France coming through. Past the start line for the 200 metres, those sprints to come on Friday and Saturday. But it is Tomicevic taking them out, gritting his teeth and driving on. A response from Jorge Antonio Garcia. It looks as if Kirchev is fading, and these two, Tomicevic and Jorge Antonio Garcia, Serbian and Cuban, locked together. Still Tomicevic with a slight advantage, but Jorge Antonio Garcia responding now as they come into the final 100 metres.
Garcia there reaching out as hard as he can, getting his body shifted forward as he just edges into the lead.
And Garcia now with the response, and he's going to bring this home. He's going to take victory in this B final, effectively ninth place. He comes in, but he celebrates as if he has won the gold medal itself. Jorge Antonio Garcia, great race, takes it from Marko Tomicevic of Serbia. Perhaps the B finals do mean something after all. Murray Stewart just coming through there in the final place in this B final. That it meant a lot there to Jorge Antonio Garcia. And it was a very, very good race with Marko Tomicevic. And Miroslav Kirchev, the Bulgarian, who just faded away towards the end. And in fact, Kirchev, I wonder if he was shaded by Cyril Carey at the top of the picture. No, he'd just come home in third, the Bulgarian. But no doubt about the winner from Cuba, Jorge Antonio Garcia.
Great shot here, showing how the athletes really drive their blades deep into the water. A well-executed race there from the Cuban. And that fantastic celebration, as if he had become Olympic champion. But ninth place.
Perhaps he thinks he has. Perhaps he doesn't know of the A-final. He's going to be disappointed when they don't sling a gold medal around his neck. We'll make up a medal, some other colour, a tin medal. Ninth place for Jorge Antonio Garcia. Victory in the B-final. And again, just look for the confirmation of the times there. Interesting to see what times they come up with. And Jorge Antonio Garcia just inside the 3 minutes 30. And you can almost guarantee that that will not be last in the A final. But you've got to get in that A final to have the chance. So. Just about ready, and this is the result of that
one,
B final.
Great Britain. In lane two, Sweden. In lane three, Norway. In lane four, Germany. In lane five, Canada. In lane six, Belarus. In lane seven, Denmark. In lane eight.
So the start list for the A final, where the medals will be decided in this K1 1,000 metres. Anders Gustafsson, you heard the roar for Tim Brabants. He goes in one, Gustafsson in two from Sweden. Erik Veras Larsson. His fourth Olympic Games, gold in this event in Athens, silver in Beijing. Max Hoff, perhaps the favorite, the giant 6'6" European champion for the last 4 years. Adam Vancouver and the Canadian, fastest time in the semi-final. World champion in this event last year in Hungary.
One minute to the start. Paddlers to the start line, please. Paddlers to the start line.
hope and expectation for the vast majority of the crowd here at Eton Dorney, but it has to be tempered by realism, by the fact that the great home favourite Tim Brabant's defending his crown, simply not in the form that carried him to gold in Beijing 4 years ago. His main goal was to reach the final and see what happens when the crowd can give you an extra lift, extra wings. But again, realistically, look out instead for Germany's Max Hoff, European champion for the last 4 years, twice world champion. Look also for Canada's Adam Van Coverden, world champion last year. Not an easy race to call, though, for the order of the medals. The first medals to be decided on this water in the canoe sprint at this Olympic Games. Rennie Poulsen from Denmark certainly in with a chance. Not at his impressive best in the heats, but Brabant's at the top for Britain. Then Anders Gustafsson, Erik Veras Larsen from Norway, Max Hoff, Adam Van Coverden, Ali Jurenio of Belarus, Rennie Poulsen of Denmark, and Francisco Cubelos Sanchez of Spain. Away we go in the A final, the final to settle the medals here in the men's K1, 1,000 metres, and the roar will grow for Tim Brabant's in lane one, closest to the spectators as they approach the stands, but who will take it out quickest?
It looked like Adam Van Coverden there, off to a fantastic start, jumped out of the bucket, and as we'd expect, he does. He leads from the early stages, really setting the pace in this race.
World champion in this event last year in Hungary, fastest time in the semi-final, this 30-year-old from Toronto, the Olympic gold medalist in Athens in the K1 500 metres, and already a length up on the rest as they try and close down. Others will set their pace at different times. And Tim Brabant's up at the top, usually goes out quickly. He's in that bunch, but it is Adam Van Coverden who's powering away to the quarterway mark, 250 metres, and he comes through ahead of Erik Veras Larsen, Rennie Poulsen, and Anders Gustafsson.
And the rest of the field will really be looking to make sure they don't let Adam get too far away, because he is renowned for these fast starts, but it's all about whether he can hold on and through that latter stage of the race, looking comfortable at the moment as he drives through those legs and connects in his middle part of his body and then drives that blade deep into the water.
Good view again from on high on our wire cam here, and from the side it looks pretty good from Adam Van Coverden as well. Almost a little bit of clear water between Van Coverden and the rest. And we look down from the finish line where medals wait for three of these men as they power on up towards getting closer to the stand. The crowds begin to grow on the left-hand side. The coaches cycling along on the towpath. Half an eye on the athletes, half an eye on the clutter of the peloton around them as well. Van Coverden really is looking impressive. Erik Veras Larsen, the Norwegian, in second at the moment. But Van Coverden, a study of concentration, of rhythm and technique. Being closed down, perhaps now though.
But looking relaxed through his shoulders, puffing a bit through those cheeks as they come into this latter part of the race. It's in those last 200 metres where the lungs start to burn. A Veras Larsen there as well, controlled as he's pulling up a bit on Van Coverden.
Does Van Coverden have the staying power? Erik Veras Larsen is in there, and that boat is creeping. That green Norwegian boat is creeping into picture, into the left eyeline of Adam Van Coverden, trying to hold them off as they come up to the stands now. And the noise swells to the final 250 metres in this men's K1, 1,000 metres. It's all about Van Coverden and Erik Veras Larsen at the moment. Rennie Poulsen in third, Gustafsson fourth, surprise. Max Hoff is down at the moment. Does he have something left? Max Hoff in lane four there is beginning to make a push into the medals as well, past Rennie Poulsen, but neck and neck for gold and silver. It's Van Coverden and Erik Veras Larsen up into the final 150 metres they come, and that's how close they are. The bows of the boat cutting through the water. Van Coverden and Larsen for the gold medal, and it's the Norwegian now pushing clear. Erik Veras Larsen from Adam Van Coverden, with Max Hoff in the bronze medal position. Does he have something left to give? Tim Brabant's further down, listening to the roars, but his Olympic crown will go to someone else, and it looks as if it's going to go to Erik Veras Larsen into the last 20 metres. He has timed it to perfection. The Norwegian Erik Veras Larsen has the gold medal from Adam Van Coverden. Max Hoff coming through for bronze. Those are the medals. And what a race we had, timed perfectly, as it so often is from Erik Veras Larsen. The veteran, 36 years old, he celebrates. He timed his push to perfection. He has the gold medal as reward.
What a well-executed race there from Erik Veras Larsen. He's renowned for coming through later, but he didn't let Adam get away from him too much. Actually came through the race a bit quicker than I actually expected him to. But Adam Van Cuverden will be disappointed not to be able to hold on to his lead in that last part of the race.
Realistically, we knew, and most of the crowd knew, that this was not going to be a successful defence for Tim Brabants. He was further down the field. He's not in the form. He's had that injury, still coming back from it. But Erik Veras Larsen, a friend of Tim Brabants, a long-time rival, we wondered if he was perhaps fading, because he is getting on a bit now at 36. But my goodness, not at all. Look at how he powered through and came through to take that goal past Adam Van Cuverden of Canada.
It was an extremely controlled performance. Put all that experience that he's had from the previous 10, 15 years behind him, and executed the race plan that he knew or hoped could get him that Olympic gold. Fantastic performance.
To go with his gold medal from this event in Athens, a silver in Beijing, he takes gold once again. Erik Veras Larsen, the champion, the first champion of this canoe sprint week here at Eton Dorney. His wife, Mira Veras Larsen, is competing here as well. She was actually the flag bearer for Norway at the opening ceremony. But there is confirmation, and as we expected, Tim Brabants not featuring there for the medals. He was here in the final to see his gold medal handed over to Erik Veras Larsen, with Max Hoff, who I thought was the favourite coming into this, only taking bronze, still a fantastic effort. But Adam Van Cuverden splitting them in the silver medal, setting the pace. But all about Erik Veras Larsen, gold medalist from Norway and the first gold medalist of this canoe sprint event here at this Olympic Games.